let's discuss the concept of apparent dip. In the previous video, we have studied about dip, declination, etc. as components of Earth's magnetic field. The dip that we studied over there, it is called true dip. So here we are going to study about apparent dip and what is the relationship of apparent dip with the true dip. So see this diagram. Here two planes are shown. PQRS is one plane, that is the original magnetic meridian plane. It is a vertical plane. And PQ dash R dash, yes, it is the plane in which you are holding the compass. Now there is no guarantee that every time you will hold the compass exactly in the true meridian plane. So there is an angle between these two planes and it is theta. Okay. Now if you see this diagram, always dip is the angle between the horizontal component and the total Earth's magnetic field. This is the true dip angle between, if you draw the diagram like this, you remember this is my BH, this is my B, this angle is my dip. Now in this diagram, it means that angle QPR, this is my true dip. But for clarity purpose, I am drawing a parallel line over here. This is my real magnetic field direction, B, and this angle is the true dip. Now, if you see here, because of this new plane, there will be a B dash pointing towards P2 R dash, and there is a apparent dip delta dash, the angle Q dash P R dash. Okay. So here, in order to establish some relationship, let us study few things. If you take this PS, this PS is the vertical component of original magnetic meridian as well as the new vertical component of B dash. If you take PQ, if you take PS, PS is BV, at the same time it is B dash V. What is B dash V? It is the vertical component of B dash. So BV can be written as B sine delta, and B dash V can be written as B dash sine delta dash. And PQ is the horizontal component. It can be written as B cos delta. Now if you observe this PQ dash, now this is tricky. PQ dash can be written in two ways. One, as a component of B dash, it is B dash cos delta dash. And if you see this picture, PQ is the original horizontal field of the earth and it is fixed. So this horizontal component of earth's magnetic field will have a component in PQ direction. Okay, this BH direction is fixed, but in PQ dash we can have a component of PQ. So PQ dash can be written as, PQ dash can be written as a component of BH, that is equal to BH cos theta. But what is BH cos theta? What is BH? It is B cos delta. So B cos delta into cos theta. But at the same time, PQ dash can also be written as a component of B dash. So it is B dash. It is B dash cos delta dash. Now we will write all these equations in one place. If you observe, in both the cases, this PS is the same. The vertical components are same. So one way of writing it as B dash sine delta dash is equal to B sine delta. This is my equation one. And this PQ dash is equal to B cos delta cos theta, but PQ dash is equal to B dash cos delta dash is equal to B cos delta cos theta. This is my equation 3. If you divide 1 by 3, this B dash gets cancelled. Sin delta dash by cos delta dash is equal to sin delta by cos delta into cos theta. If you rearrange, you get tan delta dash is equal to tan delta by cos theta. Now this is the interrelationship of apparent dip and the true dip. Suppose in any question they give you the magnetic field, Earth's magnetic field, and they give you the value of true dip and apparent dip. So you can find out the value of B dash using this equation. So here B dash is equal to, if you take sine delta dash on the other side, it becomes B sine delta by sine delta dash. So this B dash can be found out if you know the value of true dip and apparent dip.